perfect, that's what I'm determined to be. So money is nothing concerning to me. I'm burning a beat like third degree, internally damaging permanently. I'm iller than an infer-
Yo, 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 what up YouTube? Jay Santee here, and I'm coming at you with a great video here today, guys. It might be a little on the longer side, but it's going to have a lot of great information. This is going to be how to draft the absolute best team in NBA 2K15, my GM. It's a team that's going to win championships year after year, a team that's going to gradually get better, and you're going to be able to contend right away. So let's get into it. All right, guys. So you can clearly see I'm the Cleveland Cavaliers, and I have the second pick. All you really want to be focused on is just to get like in the top 15 draft picks. So let's see who you're gonna go with. You gotta remember of who you want to have a good guard-based team, because guards and occasionally the small forward are who handles the ball most. So if you think about it logically, you want your best players to be the ones that touch the ball most of the time. I'm going to go with Russell Westbrook just because he's all over the place. He's going to give me rebounds and have great defense. He can also get buckets and make a lot of passes. So there we go. I got my point guard out of the way, and that's the number one position. He's going to be touching the ball the most, and he's the best player. 25 years old, and I have him locked up for 3 years. I'm going to go with the stud, Monte Ellis. He's going to get me a lot of points. He always does. And it's never bad to have one kind of veteran. And I just think Monte is the right choice because he's a great scorer. He always has been in 2K. As you can see, 19 points a game, 19, 20, 24. So he's going to get a lot of assists from Westbrook, and it's just going to work out great. Now, here is where I might shock a lot of people. As you can see, Tim Duncan is the absolute best player, hands down, left. And you know, there's not really much really sticking out at me at this point. So it's the third round. It's an 89 overall. I figure, why not? Let's go with the old man, Tim Duncan. It's a great power forward, also another scorer. So it's really going to work out great in simulation and stuff. I'm going to go with Jay Crowder here because he's a good perimeter defender. And I don't really need a big scorer at this point because I do have Tim Duncan, Monte Ellis, and Russell Westbrook, which are going to get tons of points. Jay Crowder's just kind of lock down those small forwards and, you know, just get some boards and stuff like that. So now I have the next pick, and you always want to knock out your first five players first. Get your starting lineup and then start working on the backups. An A in rebounding. Yep, I'm going to go with Larry Sanders, a young player. Not a terrible contract. Inside D is good, and his rebounding is good. Will help out Tim Duncan a lot. So let's go with him. Now, I'm going to try to get a good guard here, because having a good guard come off your bench, your sixth pick, you really want to be your sixth man, honestly. I go my starting five, and then I get the sixth man. So let's go ahead and get the sixth man. So I'm going to go with Shabazz Muhammad here, a good sixth man, 21 years old, and he's an aggressive scorer. That's a great pickup. He'll come off the bench, can play shooting guard and small forward. Now, Tim Duncan does not play a lot of minutes because his stamina is low, so with my 7th pick, I'm probably going to pick up, Costa because he's a good rebounder, a big guy, and his inside D will get better throughout the year because he's not too old, so he will progress at a decent rate. In round 8, I have Russell, Tim Duncan, Monte Ellis, Sanders, Crowder, Kupos, and Shabazz Muhammad. So in round 8, I'm going to get that backup point guard because that's what I really need. So for the backup point guard position, I am going to go with Mario Chalmers. He has a B-minus playmaking and his perimeter defense is not bad. So he will be able to keep my team in the game when Westbrook is out. And with the ninth round, the last round I'm going to show you guys, because after this you're just kind of getting bench players and it really doesn't matter. I'm going to go with Kevin Garnett, because that makes two old power forwards, but Kevin Garnett and Tim Duncan will get their buckets and they will get their rebounds and defense. So as you can see, the team we drafted is number 1 in defense, number 7 in offense, and 3rd overall, and they're only going to get better throughout the year because they are so young. So let me simulate throughout the year and prove to you guys that this team will in fact win the championship. And after that point, it's going to be obvious that they will win for several years to come, most likely in a row. Check this out. Like I told y'all, Russell Westbrook won the MVP of the season. He really did it all for us. 22 points, 9 assists, and 8 rebounds a game with 2 steals. Absolutely incredible. Use this draft strategy, guys. I promise you it works. Also, check this out, y'all. Our team had the number one record in the league, 58-24, the best power ranking. In the last month, we went 12-0. Our team is absolutely incredible. Our rankings, our overall is 4th, defense 1st, offense is 6th. But we're the number one power ranking, which means we just drafted a good team that's working together very well. And let's see if we win this NBA Finals. So I'm just going to simulate all the way through this, just to prove to you guys that this method is perfect. This draft strategy is perfect. Check it out. I don't even have to play a game. I am just going to skip through everything. That's how confident I am that this is going to work. They have so many goals and everything for me. It's killing me. So let me simulate, guys. Alright, go all the way through. I don't want to bench Larry Sanders. Congratulations, the Cleveland Cavaliers have won the championship. Like I said, guys, this strategy is perfect. It is going to work for you. Check it out. You guys need to use this. Get 2 good scoring guards, Tim Duncan in the 3rd round. Get a good defensive small forward. And then get your big man. After that, you want to have a good guard, a good 6th man that's going to come in and be able to score and run the offense. Then you want to get a good secondary big man. Get Kevin Don't draft any other power forwards. Just get Kevin Garnett later in the draft, like 10th round. He's a good overall. Check out what my players ended. Russell Westbrook, a 97. Monte Ellis, all the way up to an 88. Our team just absolutely balled out. Larry Sanders. Everyone just got better, really, really balled out. I'm really happy. And guys, be sure to check this out. So check this out. Tell me if it works in the comment section, guys. And please be sure to share this with your friends, guys. I promise you it's going to work every time. Thank you guys for watching. And until next video, peace.